So, hello guys and welcome to the next tutorial. In this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to create a procedural rock solver or crystal solver. It's more like a abstract future alien stone. And yeah, let's get started with laser geometry and name this maybe rock underscore solver. I usually make this round and let's give it another color, maybe black. Let's dive in and place a circle. Let's make it on the CX plane and let's make it a polygon and bump the dimensions up maybe to 100. Yeah, that's good. So let's rename this to rock. Let's save this quick on desktop. Now we need this for scatter. Make a remesh. And maybe we'll make the iterations 5 so that the polygons are even. 5. So now we need a mountain. Place it underneath it. And yeah, it's pretty good for the start. Let's change the height a little bit to get random. To get it random, like maybe so. And let's scatter some points onto that. For the beginning, I make maybe 15 points. Yeah, that's good. So, now we need to copy the points. And let's make the scatter node on the right input and the rock on the left input. And now we get this. Maybe let's make it a little bit smaller. Maybe like so, yeah. And let's place down a loop for each connected piece. And let's change some stuff here. That's all right, and that's. Wait, I need to look at it. Yeah. Primitive merge each iteration and. That's all good setup. Don't change anything in here. So now we're gonna place a polyframe. And take the polyframe to primitive and to primitive centroid and detach that here and oh no, right here, and let's place in here the normals. And now we place our second mountain in here. And let's see. When you change the element size, maybe around maybe 1.2. And now change the offset, you will get a really cool displacement, but in a two-dimensional way. So now we can extrude this, like a poly extrude. And let's extrude down, yeah, maybe like so. And also output the back, or the top in this case. And let's make a group, the front and the back group, and let's make a poly bevel. First make a group, and change the group to extrude back first. that's this, and name it maybe back, or in this case top, and get the group. It's the back group, back, and now you can play with the distance here. Maybe not so much at the top, maybe a little small value, 0.059, yeah, that's good, or 0.06, that's better. So now we got the top bevel, now we need the bottom bevel, and let's make another poly bevel. Let's change this to front and make another group here. Let's change group to front and here front. Oh wait, sorry for that. That's now the bottom group, and let's polybevel it, and let's make it a little bit more, like maybe one, and let's place some segments through here. So, and now let's look at the loop, and yeah, the loop is just for the mountain, because you get, for each piece, you get other mountain, other two-dimensional form, and you can look on it with the single pass. You can go through each pass here. This is 0, 1, and so on, and you see when we change to the top viewport, every single cylindrical rock got another mountain offset applied. And let's turn the single pass on to see all the rocks. Let's change back to perspective viewport. Yeah, now you get this. So, and now you can begin to maybe transform it a little bit. Maybe stretch it. Stretch it more. And now you can begin to build a VDB from polygons. And make it maybe 0.08. And convert it again. And now you will get a mesh. Maybe let's make it a little bit detailed, more detailed, maybe 0.02. Yeah, that's better. Maybe not so high, maybe 0.04. And now we can place some noises on that. But before, I want to show you. For example, when you change here a value, let's say 3, you get a whole new form, a whole new rock form, and I like to leave this here maybe, or maybe make it here 2, and change here the rock circle to maybe 0.1. And now you get like a thin rock. And now let's gather some more. Maybe make 50. Yeah. And now you get this segmented look here. I really like that. Maybe make it 0.25. Yeah. And now you can apply some noises. Make an attribute, whoop. Connect it. And let's make here, for example, I just look Okay. Maybe let's make here a oh, no noise. Let's make a add. Take the position into the first input and the sum. First into the color. And now you can see how your Voronoi noise looks like. You can scale down the frequency. Maybe make it a little bit bigger, like so. Let's offset it a little bit. And let's make here fit range. For that, and let's bump that down. Yeah, so now you can get a little bit of displacement here, and let's change maybe the frequency. Yeah, you can make it like so, like maybe like wax, maybe, or you can change it to maybe 0.5. Wait, I just make here for the frequency, let's make a constant 0.1, 0.5. Yeah, and with these values you can play, make more noises, and I show you now a little bit other setup, it's on my other desktop, and with this setup I get this rock here. It's like a, yeah, it's a pretty abstract rock, maybe from another planet. And the only thing I did here was just some Voronoi and Worley noises. And a second noise, it's here, and it's a unified noise with the Worley cellular noise. And yeah, I hope I can help you a little bit with this quick abstract rock tutorial, and I hope you liked it. Thanks, and see you in the next video.